God sent the Quran as a guide for human beings. What an individual must do is think about each of its verses. In the Quran, God invites us to consider many things. For example, He invites us to think about our own creation. Man has only to look at what he was created from. He was created from a spurting fluid. God invites us to think about the creation of the heavens and the earth. In the creation of the heavens and the earth and the alternation of night and day, there are signs for people with intelligence. Those who remember God, standing, sitting, and lying on their sides, and reflect on the creation of the heavens and the earth. Our Lord, You have not created this for nothing. Glory be to You. So safeguard us from the punishment of the fire. God invites us to think about the transitory nature of life in this world. The life of this world is nothing but a game and a diversion. The abode of the hereafter, that is truly life if they only knew. Whatever you have been given is only the enjoyment of the life of the world. What is with God is better and longer lasting for those who believe and trust in their Lord. God invites us to consider that the whole universe was created for the sake of human beings. And He has made everything in the heavens and everything on the earth subservient to you. It is all from Him. There are certainly signs in that for people who reflect. God invites us to think about the living things that He has created. You have a lesson in livestock. From the contents of their bellies, from between the dung and blood, we give you pure milk to drink, easy for drinkers to swallow. God invites us to think about the hereafter, the day of resurrection, the day of judgment. On the day that each self finds the good it did and the evil it did present there in front of it, it will wish that there were an age between it and then. God advises you to beware of Him. God is ever gentle with His servants. An individual who reflects will understand the secrets of God's creation and the truth about the life of this world. He will recognize God's attributes in everything. Unlike most of mankind, throughout his life he will think about why he exists. He grasps the knowledge that God has taught him and begins to think as God has commanded. As a result, he will take more pleasure than anyone else in God's blessings, and he will not worry needlessly or involve himself in the care of worldly ambitions. These are only some of the wonderful things that such a thinking person will gain in this world. By thinking and always seeing the truth, in the endless hereafter, a person will gain the love, approval, mercy, and paradise of God. God calls on us, His servants, thus so that we can succeed. So set your face firmly towards the true religion, before a day comes from God which cannot be turned back. On that day, they will be split up. Those who disbelieved will find that their disbelief was against themselves. Those who did right were making the way easy for themselves, so that He can repay with His bounty those who believed and did right actions. He certainly does not love the disbelievers.